All right, guys, very good morning, very good afternoon, and very good evening for all of you guys who are all around the world. We have a good 38 people in here in the room, and let's get going. It is 7:34 now. We're four minutes over, and we're going to get started. The webinar is going to be approximately an hour. We're going to do lots of examples. We're going to go through some methods of how to draw support and resistance. Support and resistance is by far one of my favorite things to use in terms of trading. Okay, it does make a big difference in how we trade and where the market's going to go to, where it's going to stop, all those information. It's a very key player. Okay. So we're going to go slightly for an hour, slightly over an hour. There is NFP in 1 hour at 8:30 on, if you see on my clock, it's an hour away. And Joginder, will this be recorded? I may have to go. Yes, it will be recorded, so not to worry. For those of you, if you have any audio lags or anything, you guys can still sit through it. The recording will be released. I just don't know when, but it will be released. Just going to confirm it's recording. Yes, it is recording. Okay, so good afternoon. Okay, so let's get started here. Okay, now let me open up a new account so we can keep clean charts. Joe Tazet, are we going to trade the NFP with you? No, we're not going to trade the NFP, but we can do some analysis about it and to get an idea of the sense of which direction will the NFP possibly go and how do we come to that conclusion. We can go through some of that steps. But remind me about that around 10 minutes before the NFP starts. Okay, Ronald, NFP is non-farm payroll, okay? It's not my initials, Naveen freaking Prithiani. Okay, Seb, hi Seb, how are you? Okay, so now let's get started here. All right, so what is support and resistance? To you guys, what does support and resistance mean? Okay, possible reversal areas, floor and roof. Okay, Seb says walls in the market, pivots, high mark of trend and low mark. Okay. Okay, Phil says areas of previous price interaction, some mysterious level I never know how to draw. Okay, support comes resistance. Okay, so yeah. All those answers are pretty much correct. Now, basically, a support or resistance is, it can do three things. When a market reaches a support or resistance level, it can either push back, it can reverse from it, or it can halt at that area. Okay, these are the three things a support resistance areas do. Now, depending how strong a support and resistance level is, I understand how strong it's gonna push back, if it's gonna halt, or if the market has enough momentum to like break through. Okay. Usually to break through a strong level, you need a news. Okay, if it's a very strong level, you need a news. So let's get back to how do we draw these levels? How do you guys draw your support and resistance? What is your methods? Okay. What are your methods for drawing support and resistance? Okay, let me clean up my charts here. Phil says automated, cannot type, automated on T4, previous lows and highs, look for supports, highs and lows, 3 days previous, Look for it 3 days to 1 month back. Okay. Tails, congestion, testing of price, pivot points, look for big tails, pivots to holding in the path. Okay. So today what we're going to do is I'm going to teach you guys how to draw support resistance properly. How to find out where we have support and resistance, and what are some of the tools we can use for support and resistance. Everything. Okay. So let's go through them right now. Okay, if you guys want to take notes, you guys are welcome to take notes. This video will be recorded. I just don't know when I'm going to release it. So if you have to take notes, go ahead and take notes. Okay. Okay, Jota Z says, too many theories to put into practice. Okay, okay. Okay, I'm going to give you some ways to do it that will make life a little bit easier. Okay, now, Euro USD. Okay, let's go further back. Okay, so support and resistance is nothing but a wall. Okay, do not go too much into detail of what it actually means, because it's nothing but a wall. A wall that's trying to hold the market. Okay, now, support and resistance can be drawn in several ways. Okay, one way is the method of the body versus the tail. Okay, what does that mean? Okay, does everyone know what a body is on a candlestick? And what is a tail? Okay, yes, yes, yes. Okay, so in this particular case over here, if I take our line and then I draw it all the way up to the body, leaving the tails out of it, a tails is nothing that our tails have no significance technically in terms of support and resistance. If you draw it onto the body, you can see that the market has never closed outside of this level. Okay, this is how you can draw a proper range in the market. If you want to draw, to see if the market's in a range or not, we can get into that. We're going to get into that little by little. Okay, when you draw till here, you know where your level of resistance is. The market may go above and beyond it in tails, but it ends up closing inside of it. Okay. However, you are crossing the bodies on the third day to the left. Okay, no, but we're focusing on this area here. Okay. Now, there is a different whole different meaning, Jota Z, in terms of strength. How much strength this level holds determines by how many times this level has held again and again in the past. And we're going to go through that. Okay, so I'm going to go through some more examples of the body versus tail method, and you guys are going to tell me if it's correct or incorrect. Okay, I'm going to go through some correct ones first, and then I'm going to try and trick you guys to see if you guys still understood it. Okay, so, okay, everyone see how this resistance is drawn? No body outside of it. Okay? It held true again in the future. Okay? No body outside of it. Okay, let's move on. Support. Okay. Okay. Minor support here. No body outside of it. Okay. Makes sense so far? Okay. Hello, Patrick. Welcome to the room. Okay. Let's go through some more examples. There we go. Resistance, resistance, resistance. No body outside of it. Okay. And then we crashed outside finally after that. Okay, so now let me draw some and then you tell me if this is correct or incorrect. Is this a correct resistance level? Okay, yes. Okay, now let's discuss some things about this resistance level. What makes this resistance level significant? Okay, now how do you determine a strength of a support and resistance? What makes a support and resistance good? Okay, Kevin by tails, Ronald touched many times, how many times tested, Craig correct, Ronald also correct, Kevin also correct. Okay. Big tails never crossed. Okay, so this is one of the methods I teach to my members in the conference room. Whenever you have a candle that is big and has big tails coming from it, for example, this one, we have a massive strength coming north, and then it creates a tail from this area. Strong resistance. Massive tail once again. No body outside, strong resistance. It holds the market once again, strong resistance. Okay, and then we have small tails after that. Small tails, okay, big deal. Okay, once again, a massive level here. So, can we assume this area is a strong area? 2317. Okay. Does it hold true in the future? Okay. It crossed through to the north. Once support and resistance gets once a resistance gets crossed through, what does it become? Okay. It becomes support. Okay. A level that is strong and it's crossed through then becomes the opposite. Okay. If this is a resistance and it's crossed through, it then becomes support. Okay, now, a couple things to monitor. If it's a strong resistance, the cross-through must happen through a strong candle. Okay, if you look at this candle, is this the biggest candle of the day? Yes. Okay, the strength of the candle must be the strong a strong one to cross through it. Okay, and then close outside of it. The next candle opened up. You can see it created a tail. But no body. Went up. Went further down. Let's see if we can find another test of this area in the future. Okay. Strong cross through. And once again, it now uses it as a resistance now that we've crossed below it. Okay. Once again, it uses it as pinpoint. As resistance. Okay, it tried to contain the market one time here, created a tail. Next candle is way too strong, crossed through it. Now it becomes support. Support here, pinpoint. Okay, strong candle crosses through. Does everyone agree? That must be a strong candle to cross through. This also is a strong candle to cross through. Okay, so is everyone following me so far? How do you determine a strength of a support and resistance? Okay, if support resistance is drawn well, you can pretty much pick it up at pinpoints. Okay, again, it crossed through, but with the biggest candle of the day, once again. Okay, the next candle it opened up, take a look. It used it as support exactly to pinpoint. Okay, this level has been tested again and again and again. Take a look here. Okay. Tails here, big candles crossing through. So, now, You can write this down. If a level has been used as support and resistance multiple times, the same level, there is strength. Okay. If that level has contained a large tail, such as this one, it has more strength. Okay? You can put that as strength level number 2. Okay. Now, let's go into the next segment of support and resistance. How else can you draw support and resistance? Okay. Let's say this is the current day. This is as far as we see the market so far. Okay. This is as far as we've reached. Let me go into here. Okay. Current day, and this is as far as we've reached. We haven't seen anything past this. Okay. Where is our nearest resistance? What price approximately is our resistance at? Is it here? Okay, no, no, lower. No, lower, 2294. Good, good, to the body. Okay, this is our resistance here. Okay, now, before we go any further, let's test, is this level a strong one? Let's go back. Do we have data from the past telling us this? How far back can we go? Okay, Oscar says 3 days. Nelson, as far as possible, as far back. Ronald says month. Okay, Farhan says as far as you want. Okay, as far as the data. Okay. The answer is as far as the data goes, yes. Now, am I going to go back 10 years? No, of course not. I don't have time to do that. Okay, you go back as far as it actually holds. Okay, what do we see here on 19th of July for this same level? Okay, it used it as resistance. Okay, created a tail. A little bit outside. Okay, a little bit we can look over. Just a little body outside. Okay, let's go further back. Okay, do we have some pinpoints here? Okay, remember, it is still resistance. Okay, resistance. It's still resistance. Do we have a large tail yet? Ronald, it is handy to go back, but I'm just using it for the sake of an example right now. We're scrolling little by little. Okay, no big tails yet, so we don't know the strength of this level. All we know is that in the past, it's held true as a resistance. Okay, go further back. Okay, almost pinpoint. Okay, now take a look at this area here. What do we have here? Resistance, and once it crosses above, does it use it as support? Okay, what do you guys see of this area? Consolidation, yes. Now it's just whipsawing up and down of this area. Okay, now, when we're in a whipsaw, we need to watch for certain things. How are the whipsaws created? Are they done, whenever they cross this level, are they done by large candles? Okay, small candle, held. Large candle, didn't. Okay, makes sense. So, support there. Resistance, here. Pinpoint resistance. Market continues. Resistance, once again. It held. Okay, now we have a large candle. Is this the biggest candle that you see so far? Yeah, cross through. Okay. And then we had some choppiness here. So, one area of choppiness. Okay, it continued to hold through after that. It held through again. Okay, crossed through, and then it used it as support once, support twice, crossed through, resistance one, two times, big candle crossed through, came down, big candle crossed through, and then resistance again. Did this level actually hold? Okay, your supports are not looking very clear. Resistance, yes. Okay, Hassan says, I personally didn't like it. Okay, Ronald says, only a day. Okay, so let's go a little bit further back. See, okay, looks like the data further back doesn't come down. Okay, so moving back to where we were. Let's go back. So we know this area has some level of significance. Okay, the resistance does quite well. Okay. A little body is closing outside, okay? So, and then we have some more here. So we know that it does hold as resistance for a little bit, but it's weak. This level is weak, okay? When it's weak, what does it mean for you? Okay, can the market break through this level? Yes, okay. That's what a weak versus strong resistance or support. That's what it means. Can it contain the market? How strong is the support and resistance? Can it contain it? Can it not contain it? That all of this has a factor. Okay, so now we go back to our regular day. Where were we? Okay, we were on this day. We continue. Okay, big candle crosses through. It uses it as support. Big candle crosses down. Uses it as resistance. Big candle crosses up. Okay, uses a support, and then take a look at this. Is that a big candle? Okay, this level no longer has respect. Look at that, the market's just flying right through, in and out. No more respect for this level. Okay, levels have changed. Okay. Everyone with me so far? Okay, let's do some more examples. Okay, what pair? Pick a pair. Give me a pair you guys like. Okay, Faran says Euro Yen. Take a look at Euro Yen. All right, now, Euro Yen. Oh, sorry, let's go back a little. And let's do a support level now. Find me a support level. Okay, give me a random date. Okay, August 13th. Okay, let's go to 13th. All right, so we're gonna use support levels. Okay. Is my support here? Maybe a little lower. Okay. Why is it not here? Okay, day before broke through, previous day, tail, not body, big candle breach. Okay. But did this level hold on this day? Take a look. It contained the body here, right? Tail here. The next candle, it was a big candle, crossed through. The following candle, big candle, crossed through. So we're going to assume, okay, this level has some significance. That's why it's held in the future twice, three times. Now, how do you make this into a a understanding of where is the actual market going to go. Now, here's the thing. Here's the next lesson. When you reach levels like this, and you see in the past that it's held true, okay, you take the level that you guys are assuming right now is this level that you guys want also. This one gives you pinpoint here as well. You now have a range you're working with. This is your range for your support. Okay, remember, always remember, support and resistance does not mean pinpoint areas where you need that exact number or nothing. No. Support and resistance can also mean an area, a congestion, a consolidated zone. In this case, it's over here. Does that make sense? Okay, now let's go in the past and see this area, and then we go into the future and see if it's actually held. Okay, first let's go to the past. Okay, let's hope the market does come down actually. Okay, do we see some strength here? Big candle crossing through, but then the following candle bounces there, tail coming out of there, crosses through, it's held. Let's go here. Okay, big candle crossing through, it's held this area here, held here, all of this area. Okay, and then some whipsaws, some congestion here. Okay, it did contain it here once again. Take a look, the bottom of this place. Okay, so the significance of this little range here makes sense. Big tail here, support, all over this place. Okay, resistance from here, big candles crossing up and down. Okay, see now, which level is holding now? It's the upper line that's holding now. Even here, it's the upper line. Okay, but the bottom line holds true at this time. So this zone is a zone that we need to watch. It's a level. This is why you see the markets even bouncing from in between the levels. It's because you have this zone going on. Okay? Now, let's move into the future a little bit. See, it's held as support and resistance in the past. Not very much large tail, probably one large tail we saw. So it has a little bit of significance. Does the market actually even come down? No. The market never came back down from there. Okay. So, but everyone understand the concept so far of how the range and the zone works. Should we do one more example of the range or zone? Okay. Let's do another example for this. Now, give me a pair. Any pair you guys want? Okay, Jodah Z, how about EU today? Okay, take a look at EU today. Euro USD. Only problem with the we're doing on a date like today, how I cannot show you how we can test it in the future. That's the only problem. I can help you do this right here. Okay, resistance right here. Held through all this time. Big candle broke through. This is now support. And time will tell. This is now support. Okay, can we do Aussie dollar? Okay, many people want Aussie dollar. Oh, you guys like Australian dollar. Okay, let's take a look at Australian dollar. What day? Okay, before we continue into yesterday. Okay, we'll do yesterday. Okay, now, actually, it's going very hand in hand with what I want to show you. Okay. Is this a level of resistance? Yes. Okay. Yes. This is a level of resistance. No body outside. It's been touched several times. Let's go into the past a little bit. Oh, sorry. Let me turn off this. Let's go into the past a little bit, see if it's held. It's held through here, big tail here, okay. And then we got a little whipsaw here. Okay, maybe, maybe not. Level is not that strong. Okay, so let's go into the future. Okay, future comes out. Is this a big candle? No. Okay, there are bigger candles than this one, much bigger ones. These are the average size candles. And we're just chopping right through it. Okay, so the strength of this resistance is not so strong. Many people might think, oh, it's the high area of the day and this must hold some significance. No. You know, get some data. What? Why is it significant? Is it just because it's a high from yesterday? No, that makes no sense. Okay, just because it's a high and low of a certain day, it has no relevance of strength. Strength is only determined as if it's held again and again and again in the past. Okay, so continuing on forward, there are levels how you can measure right by looking at the same chart. When you have levels like this, you see how there's a tail pushing out from here? At the next candle, same area, the tail pushes out the other way. Does everyone see that? Yes, yes, yes. Put your line at that area. Okay. This level will have some level of significance. And in the immediate future, it held over here for 3 hours. Okay, you could do that same over here. Okay. The high of this day gave you a little significance here. It held as support and as in resistance. So coming in the future, this level will have minor support. Okay, when you find levels like this, you can go back into the past and check, you know, does this level actually have some significance? Okay, here, yes. Large tail, yes. Okay, resistance, resistance, resistance. Okay, and then some breakthroughs. Okay. And then we can go further back and back. I don't know if it goes anymore, but so minor support, minor resistance for these areas. Okay. So support resistance. Remember, three methods. Body versus tail. Okay. Method number one, where you draw on the body, not on the tail. The tails will automatically be pointed out from the past. Okay. Next method. Drawing your zones, which we need to do more examples for, yes. Okay, drawing a range. Okay, and the third method is a tail going up and tail going down from the same area. That gives you a heads up that there is level of significance here. Whether it's strong or not, doesn't matter. It tells you, check this area. Okay. Now, let's find our... Let's find our zone levels. Okay. Okay, let's draw it here. Okay. This level right here. Okay. We draw this level. Now, can we possibly draw a zone from here? What if there is a doji, Naveen? Farhan, it has nothing to do with a doji. Because even if it's a doji, it can't be a doji for 10 candles nonstop. It's the doji just on one candle, maximum the next candle after that. Okay, Jota said, some people use diagonal trend lines, moving averages. Okay, Fibonacci clusters, you do not use them. I use all of them. I do not use moving averages. I do use fibs. I do use diagonal trend lines. That's the way how I actually draw my forecast on Forex Watchers. Now, what I do actually on Forex Watchers, I draw, my staff draws now, trend lines, Fibonacci areas, and everything. And when we see a congestion of massive support and resistance on a certain area, we take the top line, we take the bottom line, delete everything in between, and draw a blue zone and say, this is going to be your sell area for the day. It's nothing but a strength of support and resistance in a certain area. And then we see... The market starting off down here, there's a massive support resistance up here. this is your area you want to sell from. Okay. Okay, so indicators just waste of time, lagging. Yes, Oscar, I couldn't agree more. Sunshine, can you please repeat that? Okay, I'll repeat that just now. Mark, is there a way we can learn how to draw the forecast? Not yet. In due time, I will teach. In due time. Little by little, step by step, baby steps. Okay. All right, Sunshine. We use fibs, trend lines, support resistance levels, and pivot points. Forexforecast.com. Okay, no, it's forexwatchers.com. And if any of you guys actually want to join our conference room, you need to get onto the waiting list. And the waiting list is at conference.forexwatchers.com. Okay. The conference room is almost full. So you'd have to get onto the waiting list, first come, first serve. Okay, so moving on. Now, let's see if we can draw some more ranges. Okay, here we go. This right here will give you a range. Okay, that is what we call a range. Multiple touches indicating that there is a range in this area. Going to the future, the bottom level held, exactly, pinpoint. Further down, big candles, and then you can see the range has been respected several times after the big candles. Boom, boom, boom. Okay, does it make sense with this range? Everyone understand the range? Can you guys excuse me one moment, please? Hello? Hey. Yeah, come by. I'm actually on a seminar. Can you get in touch with Eric and he'll. Okay. But I'm in a seminar though, so. Okay. Cool. See ya. Bye. Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. So we can say that it's okay when the levels are broken by big candles. Yes, it's always okay when the levels are broken by big candles. Because if the levels cannot be broken, then the market will forever be in a consolidation. Okay, so it has to be these big candles that break through. There must be massive strength to break through. Okay, only the big candles are allowed not to respect these levels. Okay, Jotazet, can you please explain this range idea one more time, please? Okay, yes, I will. Nasir, where you will put support and resistance, explain it, please. Okay. Kenneth from Houston, what is the next step when we reach support resistance levels? Okay, support and resistance levels basically tells you that what the market is going to do. Now, you have this sideways market going on. Okay, you have the market crossing above, crossing down, and then you get this little exhaustion. Okay, exhaustion that's been respecting this range here from the past. This gives you a heads up that we're good for a short. Okay, now, when you have this exhaustion, on the other hand, a pattern to go north, or you have this pattern to go north, what do you know in terms of your exit? You know that there is a range over here that we need to watch out for. Okay? Yes, usually your support resistance areas are pretty much the same as your pivot lines. If you actually get good at drawing them, you'll see very soon that your pivot points and your support resistance lines that you draw are pretty much the same thing. Okay, so we'll get into the pivot points too. That is also a method to use support and resistance. Okay, and most of you guys probably know that from my pro trading strategy webinar. We use pivot points for the last 3 days. If you guys do not know how that is, just go to YouTube and type pro trading strategy, and I go into that in details. All right, so this gives you a heads up that if I'm going long, how far long can I expect the market to go? Okay, gives you a heads up. This little exhaustion wannabe, if it holds true, how far will the market go? It gives you a heads up. This is why support and resistance are very useful. It gives you an idea. Okay? All right. Same for the fibs, really close to pivot points. Yes, even fibs will do that. But problem with fibs, Seb, is we do not know where to draw the high and the low. Okay, you can draw it from here to here. You can draw it from here to here. Or you can take the whole thing. So it's a big mess with fibs. Okay? So be very careful on fibs. We will go through a webinar on fibs in the future. Okay. How do you know where to take profit? Is it take profit? Take profit is the best place is with your guaranteed levels on your pivot lines. Again, it's on the pro trading strategy for that one, for the take profit ones. Okay, but again, this gives you a good heads up on your exit areas also. Okay, where the market possibly wants to exit. Okay. You wanted to do one more range. So one of you guys asked me to do the range one more time. Let's do it one more time. Okay. We have some strength here. And then the tail of this is also the resistance of this area. We got a range here. Okay. You see this area here? See how the market just bounces inside this area? Got a range here as well. Okay, big candle cross through, a small respecting the range, big candle cross through, respect again from the bottom, respect, big candle crossing through, respect from the bottom, big candle cross through, and then take a look at this, tail on top, tail on bottom. This area has significance. You guys see that? Okay. Whenever you have indications like this where there's a tail on top and then there's a tail on bottom happening, it tells you time to look in the past and see what is this area. It just gives you a heads up to say, please check me. Okay. And this will happen time after time after time. Resistance met perfectly here once again. Resistance met perfectly here. Okay, so it's been support and resistance, this whole range, again and again and again. Okay, this being one of the best examples, you know, where the body and the tail, it's been contained. All right, so, everyone good with the ranges? Take care, Jogender. Everyone good with the ranges so far? Everyone understanding the concept of a range? Kenneth from Houston, is it good to anticipate trades at support resistance levels with limit orders or wait until you see price action at support resistance levels? It's better to use your support resistance levels as ideas of where the market wants to head. You should not use this for entry specifically. Okay, that is a little bit more advanced. It's not... You need to, if you're going to do it with your entries or your exits, you need to do it with correlation. Okay, that's a whole different chapter. Okay, right now, all I'm teaching you guys is how to plot these properly and what do they mean. Okay, NFP in a little bit. Okay, so let's do some research. Okay, how many of you guys are actually from my conference room this morning? How many of you guys are actually here? Okay, Kevin, Tomai, Nelson, Donald, Richard, Ronald, not really, okay. Chart Dog. Okay, Rob, that's you. All right, so now let's take a look. Let's go through all of our pairs now. Let's do this, let's do our analysis. Okay, what do we know on EURUSD so far? What does this tell you? Okay, a couple of things. This level has significance, remember. Tail on top, tail on bottom, okay. Okay, Chart Dog says long. Hassan says still long. Just a moment, please. Long but slow down. Okay, now for those, for a lot of the members who have, who are not part of the conference room, people who are watching, what does that mean? What does it mean, long but slow down? Well, Ko Hua Hong, what is the pivots you're using? I'm using a pivot called FXI Pivots. You can actually go to urbanforex.com and you can type pivots as shown on webinar, or you can scroll down. I think it's here somewhere. No, just type in pivots as shown on webinar in the search and you'll find it. Or you can go to Forex Strategies and go under Pro Trading Strategy, this one here, and the pivots are there as well. So it's in either of those. Okay? You're welcome. Okay, so now. Okay, so Jota said, saying, how do you know it's slowing down? Okay, now when you have a candle like this, where 20% of the candle is actually giving you a tail on top, this indicates this candle is actually a trend continuation pattern, which means the market still wants to go long, but there is a chance that it might not go past the tail a lot. This is 20% of the entire candle. Okay, so it's telling you that it wants to go long, but not too much further long. Okay, there's a slowdown coming up. Pound. What do we have on pound if the market closes the way it is? Remember how we discussed pound for this resistance and support area right before we close the conference room. Could this area be the one holding it down? Okay. Large tails, large tail, large tail, large tail, and then support, 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 support. Let's go back a little. What is this area? Why does it keep bouncing? Do we have any data from the past? Not that I know of, no. I've gone back too far. So no data. Okay, so it's holding. Now, US dollar CAD. Direction. Okay, Bob, news in 10 minutes. Okay, no worries, relax. Okay, indecision. Okay, can I use your pivots in Owanda platform, Naveen? Oscar, no, you can't. You can only use it on MT4. If you have an MT4 in Owanda, yes. Anything with MT4 you can use. So just download a demo, and use it on any demos. Let's take a look at Swiss franc. Okay. Now Swiss franc took that dive as we were expecting, right? Went down short. Okay, now let's take a look at all of our pairs and find out what actually happened. Okay, what were the three pairs we were looking at today? The three pairs we wanted to identify our movement for NFP. CAD, gold, Swiss franc. Okay, let's take a look at, not Aussie dollar. Ko, this is from the conference room earlier today in our the members area. Okay, so Swiss franc, CAD, and gold. Okay, I'm just going through the recap so I can show you guys what we did today and what we're expecting from the NFP, and then we just watch and see and what really happens. But this is how we do our analysis in the room. Okay, so we take a look at gold. Okay, the 1 hour chart is not indicating much. Take a look at the 4 hour chart. 4 hour chart indicating a nice long, right? We then went down to the daily chart. Daily chart indicating a trend continuation, which is still pending. Okay, this is a trend. This is when you have an exhaustion like this. This is what we call a false exhaustion. Okay, which means the candle did not close in the previous candle for it to go short. So the market did go short, but it never went long. So this is the long is still pending, okay? Because it's pending, we're expecting that possibly to happen during the NFP. Now, how far can the long go? Probably not further than the tail, because the tail is too big. It's like 60% of the candle. So we know there's an upward movement coming up. The upward movement might stop here somewhere. Okay, that was gold analysis. The other pair we were looking at was Swiss franc. Take a look at Swiss franc on the 1 hour. Over here, we did our analysis before I left the conference room to join this conference room. We were expecting the market to slow down and turn around because we were having these massive tails coming up indicating that the market has to turn around. We had this massive drop. Let's take a look at the 4 hour. And why do we say that? Take a look. Big tail, big candle, big tail. We must respect the tail. Next candle opened up. It went north. It respected the tail's level. It went to the tip of that tail. Now it's actually turning around. So if US dollar CAD is short, US dollar Swiss franc is short, and gold is long, which direction is the overall market? Okay, long. Okay, good. We had one more pair that was giving us an indication that it's still pending. Okay, which was Canadian dollar. Let's take a look at the 1 hour charts. Not much information now because it's close to NFP. Take a look at the 4 hour charts. Let's take a look. 4 hour charts, what is this again? A false exhaustion, telling you that the market actually wants to go down. It went down. It was met. It went long also. That was met. So can we do an analysis on the 4 hour? We cannot. It's already been met, so we don't know. We skip it. We go to the daily. What do we see on the daily? Aha. We have a short, a massive candle here. Biggest one for the month. We have to respect the tail. The tail says, I'm only 10% big. The next candle must go beyond me. It went beyond it by one pip. So we're assuming the downward movement is still pending. It's still not yet respected the previous candle. Okay? So gold, long. CAD, short. Swiss franc, short. Which direction is the overall market? Okay, long. So our prediction for this is practically long. Okay, I do not recommend anyone taking this trade. I am just doing it for the sake of analysis. This is how we came up with this analysis. Okay, all the other pairs have been met. Their previous candles have been met. So for the sake of analysis, I'm going to take these trades. Okay, now there's two things that can happen in the NFP. I'm going to take these trades just as an example, okay? One moment here. Let me move my phone away. Okay, I'm going to go long here. I'm going long on pound. Okay, I'm going to go short on CAD. Let me go back to the 1 hour. Okay, I'm going to go short on the Swiss franc. Okay, I'm going to go long on Aussie dollar, sorry. Okay, I'm going to go long on New Zealand dollar. Now, another thing, I'm going to give you some information, some tips and tricks. Euro yen, I'm also going to go long on that. Okay. Now, based on statistics, right, when the NFP comes out, okay, it does this little movement, usually, you know, whether it shoots north or it shoots south, and then it might shoot the other way again. Let it do its little chicken dance that it does. Once it settles down, after its movement up, down, whatever it wants to do, probably an hour or 2 hours after, the direction you see is the direction it's going to continue for the rest of the day. Okay, that has an 80 to 90% accuracy. From the past, I don't know, 5 to 10 years, it's always been doing that. Okay, most of the time. So once the NFP settles down, you can actually pick a direction where it settled down and you can see which way it wants to go. And that's pretty much the trend for the rest of the day. Okay, so however, you were saying it's slowing down on EU, so why still long? Okay, we're still long based on correlation. Okay, because gold is saying long, CAD is saying short, Swiss franc is saying short. So based on that, we went long. Okay, from the 1 hour chart, yes, it looks like it's slowing down. Could it mean that the NFP might go short on this exact 1 hour? Maybe. And then end up going long for the rest of the day? Possible. But based on analysis, this is what we've done, and we're currently watching it. So currently I'm running at what, 11, 16 pips negative, and then we just wait and see how the analysis plays out in terms of pending pairs. Okay, remember, we're only using three pairs to do the analysis. All the other pairs, all the conditions have already been met. So this is a risky analysis. That's why I do not recommend anyone taking this trade, but we can watch it and see how we come to a conclusion that we don't need to turn on the news, but we just have an idea what the NFP wants to do. Okay, hi, this is HerdL. Is the webinar available afterwards? Yes, it will be available afterwards. Okay. Ronald, so wait for the market to calm down again, and that's the correct direction for the day, statistically speaking. Yes. Okay, the markets took a jump downwards first. It went to 70 pips. Now it's at 18. Okay, so it's doing its little dance right now. Okay, it went as far as 20 pips. Now it's back to zero. Is that an exhaustion candle on euro yen? Okay, let's take a look. On euro yen. On the previous candle, possibly yes. Okay, it's not a clear exhaustion though, it's very small. The next candle opened up, it did go short, but not so clear. Okay, while this is playing out, any questions so far? Any questions in terms of support and resistance? Anything you guys want me to repeat? Thought that gold is correlated to US dollar. Gold usually goes closely with Euro, USD, Pound, Aussie dollar, and New Zealand dollar. See, if gold goes long, it doesn't go with Euro USD, it drags Euro USD. Okay, remember, gold is not a currency. It's a tangible good that's running out. It has more strength and value than currencies. Okay, Richard, look at gold. Okay, let's take a look at gold. Okay, so gold is having a nice day. All right, so let's, I'm missing some questions here. Thought that gold is correct. Okay, is that correct? Jim? No, thanks. Can you draw the range on Euro-Yen? Okay. Euro-Yen for yesterday, okay. Jota said, how far in time you search for levels of support, resistance, strength to determine? As far as it holds true. You can go back maybe even 5 days and see, okay, it's holding true again and again and again. You know it's strong. You don't need to continue monitoring it. But if you go back only 2 days and you see the market going in and out of the range, that it's not respecting it, there's no need to go further back. You already know it. This level is weak. Does that make sense? Okay, Tom says, check out gold, please. Okay, this is the gold screen. Okay, I do have to do our range for Euro-Yen yesterday. Okay. Naveen, you have taken US dollar CAD, but it's not acting with the other pairs. Will you exit that trade? No, I always enter together, exit together. And there's no need to exit. It's only 3 minutes into the candle, 3 minutes into the news. The news plays out for a good 10, 15 minutes. Many people, they come late to the NFP, they join, they put in money. Many people, they buy, they exit, they buy again, they sell. A lot of the gamblers are getting ready to buy and sell for the next 30 minutes until they run out of money. Okay. If you see this in your favor, should you close? Not quite yet, because you have to see how far will it go. Is it going to be the direction for the rest of the day? If it is, then you leave it running, right? There's no point of closing. Okay. Hassan, do you prefer that we check support resistance areas at the beginning of every day or just when we see it? Beginning of every day is good. That's a good question, Hassan. Yes, beginning of every day is the thing what you need to do. You need to check support resistance. The next thing is as the candles are going, you need to check these areas where you have tail on bottom, tail on top, you draw a line there, significance. Okay, you can make it more precision, even this area has. Okay, tail on top, tail on bottom. And then you can go into the past and check that. That's when you know you can check it intraday. Okay? All right, so one of you, I think Farhan had a question on euro yen. Let me cover that before it gets too late into the other questions. You wanted to do a range yesterday on, okay, do you guys mind if I close this out for a moment so I can see it better? I'll bring it right back up after I'm done with the range. Okay, so now, let's take a look here. Now, what do we have here? We have this area as support, or resistance, right? Yes, it's holding true here, and it holds true here. And then it breaks through, and it holds as a tail there. Okay, do we have a range on this one? What is this area here? Tail on bottom, tail on top. What is this? Okay, it's held here also. Is this the range? Let's check the past. Okay, let's check the past. These two lines. Okay, yes, this range has been holding this area. Let's go further back. Okay, once again. Okay, still resistance. Okay, I want to see if there's support. This is the old range. Let me delete this old range so we don't get confused. Okay, I don't think it goes. Now let me just check daily charts and find out. Okay. Holds true here, and then how many times it holds as support. Okay, let's take a look on these days. 26 June, huh? Okay, further back. Okay, my data doesn't go that far. Okay, it's going very slowly. But okay, held true here. Okay, held true here. Okay, held this area. Held all of this area, big tails. So this is your range. It's held as support also. Support pinpoint, support in the range, support in the range. Okay, pinpoint, big candles break through, now acts as resistance. Okay, Farhan, so does that make sense for the support resistance for this range of euro yen from yesterday? It has strength. Okay, Andrea, can you ask me? Can you ask the question again? What tails were you talking about? Okay, was that resistance then? Farhan, it was resistance. It's broke through the resistance. Now it's support. Okay. How would you have traded it yesterday? I don't think I've traded this yesterday. Okay. Once this came out, the tail on top, tail on bottom, we can draw a line. Okay, of course. The tail on top, the tail on bottom method happens with bigger candles. Don't do it with small candles. Okay. Once that happens, you draw the line and then you can find out, is there a significance? Okay. If there were, the next candle, you would know that there's immediate support over here. And you would use that. Usually, wouldn't that have been a sell area? Remember, it is not a buy and sell area. This is not a buy and sell area. It is only a buy and sell area if you can confirm it in correlation with other pairs. Okay, this is not a signal to enter long or short. Okay, Andrea, long tails that is in an uptrend and downtrend. Okay. When you have a tail going up and a tail going down, right where the tail starts for up and down, you draw a line there. And then that gives you an indication. Please check the past to see if I have significance. Okay. Jota said, do you need big candles with tails on top and tails on bottom to define a range? No. No. A range can be defined by the bodies. Take a look. There's a body here. How many times has it been tested? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all those times. And then we use the same thing. The moment you start the drawing of this top line, that's the same moment you take the bottom. Okay? So we take the bottom here. The bottom of this tail becomes the bottom of these bodies. This is your range. It's a range-bound market. That's how you draw a range. Okay? And it also confirms that the bottom is strong because of this big tail bouncing from the bottom of the range. But this has strength on the bottom. Okay. Naveen, when I usually try to find out the support resistance, I come with so many that most of my chart becomes blue zones. What's my problem? Draw only strong ones, don't draw weak ones. If it's weak, delete it. Okay. Running at 42 pips profit, even though euro yen is in massive loss at 48 pips. Why are we in profit? Okay, my conference room members, why are we in profit? Okay, I really drill my conference room members. I really get on their case, but I think they like it, so it's okay. Many pairs on the money, euro yen probably lagging. Okay, good, good. Yes, but you do it in a nice way. Yeah, just because this is on recording and you're afraid I'm going to cancel the membership, huh? No, I'm just joking. Craig, yes, euro yen getting better price. Okay. Yes, it's the same thing. Who said that? Oh, it was you who said that. Okay. Kevin, also. All right, so overall, the market did play chicken, right? We went minus 1,000, now we're plus 1,000. So what is going on? Do I really need to see the news? I'll have white hair in no time. If I turn on the news and I watch those numbers and then I start freaking out and I have to pull the trigger on the minute, I will go crazy. I'll go crazy, I'll lose a lot of money, and it's no use. We took our time, we did the analysis, not now, not just 10 minutes ago, but we did it an hour ago. Okay, does everyone agree that when you do your analysis properly and you take your time, things actually unfold for you? Okay, Andrea, how long do you wait when it breaks through? When what breaks through, Andrea, can you clear that up so I can explain it? You mean the support resistance? Okay. While I answer Andrea's question, conference room members, which direction is for the rest of the day? Are we sure? Has the market settled down? Okay. Rich, is this being recorded? Yes, Rich, this is recorded. It will be available on YouTube. Richard Gaura, could euro yen be leading? Possible. Okay. How do we know if euro yen is leading or lagging? How do we know that? Did I miss Andrea's question? Just a moment. No, she didn't retype it. Okay. Where in YouTube? A webinar. It's going to be on YouTube. It's going to be on youtube.com/urbanforex. That is the channel. It's going to be available there. Those of you who are on the waiting list, of course, I'm going to release this to everybody in the waiting list so they can see that what we do in the conference room is not, you know, we're not just wasting time and stealing money from people. You know, we're actually doing something useful. Okay. Now, going back to the question, how do we know if euro yen is lagging or if it's leading? What's the indication for that? Okay, Ko Hua, how is euro yen correlated to these currencies? It's actually indirectly through US dollar. Ko, you can actually go on to Owanda. Okay, when you type Owanda currency correlation on Google, take the first link, this one here, and once you go in, you can click on heat map, right here, heat map, and when you click on euro yen, which is this one, Everything that is in dark red for a long period of time, it means it's going together. Everything that is blue, it means it goes opposite. So Euro-USD and Euro-Yen, same direction. Pound-USD, same direction. Okay, New Zealand dollar, USD, same direction for the most part. Aussie dollar, a little bit. But opposite US dollar CAD, opposite Swiss franc. Okay, hope that makes sense. All right, so closing this back down here. All right, so Andrea, how long do you wait before you enter the market once it breaks through? Well, again, the support and resistance levels are not an entry zone unless you're using correlation. I will have to do that. I will have to do a webinar on correlation by itself and what it means for support resistance, what it means for trend continuation, what it means for entering, all of that stuff. Okay. So Andrea, as of right now, don't worry about entries and exits. We will do one more webinar for that. So please, I hope, sorry I can't answer that question now, but stand by for that webinar. Otherwise, this webinar will get too long. Okay, so those of you who were answering, now take a look at this. We went down to 70 pips, right? We're at 92 pips now. Euro-Yen continues to drop, yet our profits continue to rise. Why? What is going on? F. Hyatt, yes, we will do a correlation webinar, don't worry. Okay, Ronald, if the correlated pairs are slowing down at resistance support levels, then Euro-Yen is lagging and vice versa. Ahmed says anti-correlation. Kevin says support on Euro-Yen. Okay, Sardaruddin says other pairs are going long. Okay, now, it's retraced slightly less than before. Before it went halfway, now it's gone slightly. And we're up at the highest level of profit now, at 130 pips more or less is the highest. So, what does this mean? This means that the other pairs seem to be leading the market. Okay. Step number one, other pairs seem to be leading the market. Step number two, what do we see? Do the other pairs, are any of the pairs who are actually going long, are they showing you any signs of tails on top showing pressure from north? Okay. No pressure on New Zealand dollar. Okay, what about Aussie dollar? At any tail on top showing pressure? Okay, no. Swiss franc, any tail on bottom showing pressure? No. Now, what does that mean? If Swiss franc goes short, Aussie dollar goes north, which direction should Euro yen go as per correlation? Long, right? Now, is Euro yen showing signs that it possibly may go long? Yes, we know that because it's creating this tail. This tells you the other pairs are leading and Euro-Yen is lagging. And this also gets confirmed by our crazy P&L that's just running away. Even though Euro-Yen is almost still at the same area, the P&L is still running. Okay, yeah, this is some of the stuff I teach in the conference room. We do this pretty much every day, but again, those of you who are watching, I'm sorry to make this sales pitch. If you do want to get in the conference room, you have to get onto the waiting list. And the waiting list is here, http://conference.forexwatchers.com. Okay. Is still discounted. Yes, you will still get the discount if you are not filled up yet in the room. We have a certain level that we're trying to fill up with the discount. After that, it's full price, and full price even seems expensive for me. So some people can afford it. I personally can't afford it. Okay. Farhan, I'm confused on where to draw top and bottom range. Okay. Okay, let's take a look at this, Farhan. I'm going to close this one out. I'm going to do one more top and bottom of the range, and then we're going to have to end the webinar. The recording's gone way too long. I won't be able to upload this on YouTube because my upload speed is fabulous in China. Okay, let's do top and... Okay, now, we did a range for the north, right? Let's do a range for the south. Okay. Euro yen. Okay, we have this area here. Okay, it's held over here, it's held over here, 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 and here, and here. Okay, resistance. Next level. What do we have for the next level? Is this another, the bottom? Is this correct? First tell me, is the top one correct? If the top one's correct, say top, yes, so I know. Okay, top, yes. Okay, is the bottom one correct? Okay, no, short term. Faran, you are correct on this one. The bottom one is not correct. Because take a look, how many times the market's disrespecting this level? In and out, small candles going in and out of this thing. Okay. Let's take it to the next level. What about here? Does this make a little bit more sense? Okay, it's a lot better, right? We have one disrespect, but it makes a lot more sense. That is your range. Yeah? We go back to the past to check this. Works here, to the tip. From body to tail, took the whole thing. Let's go further back. Boom. Body and tail. Okay, holds it down over here, holds it down over here. And then we have some whipsaw. Holds it down here. Big tail's coming out, big tail's coming out. Okay, holds it down over here. Inside all of this area, held down. Okay. And then some more whipsaw. So, is it strong? Is this level strong? Okay. If I were to rate this from 1 and 10, 1 being weak, 10 being strong, this would be a 7 or a 6. Because of all the consolidation we just saw in the back. Okay. This holds true really well over here, but not so well on the back. So, this will have smaller significance in the future. Okay. It will hold. It will push the market. But it will not be able to, push very big candles like this. It can push medium-sized candles like this. Does it make sense? The strength of your support resistance on what it can push and what not. Okay, so I wonder how would a score 10 look like? Kevin, why don't you do me a favor? Whenever you see a 10 score that you think it's a 10 score, take a screenshot, put it on Urban Forex, and ask me to comment. I will go and take a look at it. And I will tell you if that's a 10. Okay. All right, so I'm going to have to go ahead and close the webinar here as it is 8:53. We've gone 23 minutes past. Okay. Trades on my end running at 170 pips. Looks like this seems to be the direction of the day. The market closes in 7 minutes. Did everyone understand how we had gold on this one? Okay. Take a look at the 4-hour. 4-hour held through. Okay, the daily, did the daily finally meet its condition? Okay. So, yes. So all in all, looks like this is the direction for the day. And those of you, who, if you guys do want to make a few pips here and there, wait for a small retracement, find it, entry, and then pretty much the market should be long for the rest of the day. All right, guys, for the conference room members, I'm going to leave these trades open. I think I already have the other trades open. And then we'll take a look on Monday on how this current trades ended. I'm going to leave the trades open. How do you decide when you will close the trades? I'm going to close these trades Monday. Okay, just based on statistics, you have to trust your analysis. If it goes against you, it goes against you. But trust your analysis. Okay, guys, have a very good night, guys. I will see you all very soon with another webinar, hopefully. Thank you all for attending. Once again, if you guys do want to join our conference room, it's a paid service. Please do get onto the waiting list at conference.forexwatchers.com. Thank you so much for watching. Have a very good night.